Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video we are going to describe and demonstrate our semiconductor devices characteristics trainer. So in this device we have introduced 20 different type of semiconductor family devices whose characteristics can easily be find out by experiments through this kit. So now we will move on to the experiment section. So this is our trainer kit of semiconductor devices characteristics. So here we have installed 20 different types of semiconductor devices which its characteristics can be find out with the experiment. We are also providing a user manual. The order code for this training kit is 36184. You can use this order code to send us queries through visiting our website at www.tesca.in. Now I will describe you the different features of this characteristics which we will show. Start with the DC voltmeter. So this is the DC voltmeter in a dual selectable range. It can work on up to 2 volts and 20 volts. The range can be selected with this toggle switch. Similarly, there is a DC voltmeter again from 20 volts to 200 volts. So you can select range from up to 20 volts or up to 200 volts by this selector switch similarly. So there is a DC ammeter. So this can be measure current range up to 200 milliampere to 20 milliamps, and selectable range can also be provided with this toggle switch. And in further we have DC ammeter from 20 milliamps to 200 milliamperes range. So this can be also selected with this selector switches. Now there is an IC regulated DC supply of 3 different types of supply. In this we have provided 1.5 volts, 10 volts and 30 volts. All the supplies can be vary from 0 to the maximum range which I have selected from this potentiometer. The output can be find out at these terminals which are positive negative terminals of all the DC supply. Similar supplies is provided on the right side also to use in 2 types of supply in the different experiment combinations. Now there is a 10k potentiometer also provided from 0 to 10k resistance port. So this port is required to use in experiments. This is the power on off switch of this kit. So this kit has a jewel light. When the power is on, the jewel light will be glowing. So there is also a regulated DC power supply at 100 milliamps which is from 0 to 70 volt DC, and the positive negative outputs are also provided here, and this supply can vary from 0 to 70 volts DC. So now we move on to the description of different semiconductor devices which are installed in this kit. So we will start with the diodes. So there are germanium and silicon diode, both are provided to find out the characteristics of both the type of diodes. Also providing a Zener diode and a LED to find out all the characteristics. You can find out characteristics of both the diode, Zener and LED. Now moving on, we have in the transistor NPN and PNP, both type of transistor are also provided. Optocoupler, which is a useful device in semiconductors, phototransistor, similarly photodiode also. And now moving on, there is a diac, which are semiconductor thyristor families, also thyristor, which is SCR, silicon control rectifier also. There is triac, varicap diode, with this capacitor and diode are combined, is a combination of varicap diode, VDR, voltage dependent resistance, and LDR, light dependent resistor. So the both are also provided to find out the characteristics and working profiles. IGBT insulated gate bed bipolar transistor also provided. MOSFET metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor is also provided to find out the characteristics, and FET field effect transistor, UJT unijunction transistor, and thermistor, both type of positive temperature coefficient and negative temperature coefficient, which is PTC and NTC type of thermistor, are also provided to find out the characteristics. Similarly, we have also provided some type of resistance in which we have included 100 ohm of 10 watts resistance, 1k and another 10 ohm resistance in 5 watts, 300 ohm resistance in 5 watts, and a capacitor of 0.1 microfarad to use in experimental purpose. So these are all about this kit description. User manual is also provided to find out and to do the experiment of different type of semiconductor devices. Also offering some patch codes to the connections, and all connection circuit diagrams are given in the user manual. You can do the all the experiments. So now I will explain you some of the experiment doing this on this kit. So now we will start with our first experiment, which is to study the characteristics of a germanium and silicon diodes. So these are the two diodes, and the theory of the both of the diodes and the different characteristics type are given in the user manual. You can study the theory with this user manual, and the characteristics of reverse and positive type of characteristics of a diode is given as the graph, and all about the diode is given in the user manual, a basic theory. This is the procedure for experiment, and this is the circuit diagram here given to the forward characteristics of a diode. For this we will do the circuit setup is given in the diagram, and we will follow all the procedure given in the user manual. So after connecting all the diagrams, we will find out the graph of a forward characteristics in the user manual as per the user manual. So for this we will start doing the connections. For this we will require 1.5 volt supply, which is given in the user manual already mentioned. So first turn this knob to the 0 and this knob to the 1.5 volt. And now we will do the connections. So for positive will be going to 1k resistance, and after 1k resistance there is a 10k port, and other end of this 10k port is going to the negative. Now the one end of this 10k port will be taken further, so this will be going to the 200 milliamps to microamps emitter. So this will be the ammeter, and the negative of this ammeter in further going to the diode. So we will connect the anode of a silicon diode or a germanium diode, whichever you want to do experiment. In this we are using the silicon diode, so we will do the experiment from silicon diode. Now we will connect the other end or cathode of the diode to the ground as described in the user manual. Now we will also connect the other end of this 10k port to the voltmeter of 20 to 200 volts voltmeter. So this is the voltmeter here, and this should be also going to the ground terminal. So that's how you do the connections as per the circuit diagram. Now first, after doing the connection, just verify connections with this your trainer and education teachers that your connection has been done before turning on the kit. So after verifying your connections, just turn on the kit. So now after verifying the connections, we will power on this kit. So as I power on this kit, you can see the DPM showing some values which are zero. Now for doing the, before applying the voltage, just turn this 10k potentiometer knob around the middle, so you can save the current range. Now as we increase the voltage as described in the manual, so first we will increase the voltage about 0.2 volts. So this is about 0.2 volts here, you can see in the voltmeter. So this is around 0.2 volt. So write down the voltage and current at this time, and measure the, plot the graph. Similarly, as we increase the voltage, you can find the current is increasing in larger amount and exponentially increasing. So increase the voltage till the voltage reading are increasing, and write down the current corresponding to this reading. So as I increasing the voltage and in a small increment, the current is increasing in large amount. So that's how the diode works. You can find out after plotting the graph between voltage reading and current reading, you will find out the forward characteristics of this diode. So this is how you find the graph. You can see at 2 volts the current is in very low range, and after 2 volts the current increases exponentially. So this is the characteristics of a diode in forward mode we have find out with this. So now we will start with our next experiment, which is to study the characteristics of a PNP and NPN small signal transistor. So the theory of a bipolar transistor is given in the user manual. You can study the theory with the different regions. Now we will do an experiment which is a common emitter mode. We will find out the characteristics of input in the common emitter mode of a transistor. So for this, we will do the NPN circuit, NPN transistor, the forward. This is the NPN circuit and this is the PNP transistor circuit. So we will use the NPN circuit and perform the characteristics experiment using this circuit diagram. So we will start connecting the connections on the kit. So in this experiment, we will require 1.5 volt from this side. So set this knob to the 1.5 volt and the value of voltage to the 0 point. Now we will do the connection. For this, connect positive to the 200 milliamps, 200 microamps to 200 milliamps emitter. So this is the emitter here, and the output of this emitter will be connected to the NPN transistor's base. So this is the NPN transistor over here we are providing. So the base will be connected here, and the emitter of this transistor will be going to the ground. So this is the this side of connection, which is given the input characteristics, which is the base emitter junction we have connected in this circuit. Now passing on further from collector side, use a red patch code and connect this to the voltmeter of 20 volts to 200 volts range. So this is the positive, and ground should be also connected with the ground. So this is the ground. Now we will add the emitter to the get the collector current. For this, connect this emitter positive terminal to the negative of a this voltmeter is positive to the negative of this emitter, and positive will be connected to the 10 volt supply at the right side end. So this should be selected at the 10 volts. Here we have selected this, and ground of the both of the terminals should be common. So we have common the ground of both the terminals here. Now before turning on the circuit, make sure all the voltage readings are at the zero position and verify the circuit before power on the kit. Now we will power on the kit after verifying the connections. So power on this kit here. You can see right now any of the meter is not showing any reading. Now in the experiment procedure, we have to fix the VCB, which is the collector base current, to the zero. So the collector base current should be zero at this time, and we will increase the value of VBE, base emitter junction. So this is the base emitter junction voltage here. Now we will increase the voltage and take the corresponding IB current. The IB current is connected at this emitter, so this will showing the IB current here. And as I increase the value from 0 to 1 in between, you will find the current is increasing exponentially. Here you can see as the voltage increases, the current is also increasing. So write down this reading in different steps and plot the, after taking the reading, plot a graph. You will find out the input characteristics as per the circuit given in the user manual. So this graph you will be finding out as after taking all the readings. Repeat these steps by changing the VCE around 1 volt. So we will change the VCE to 1 volt. So this is the collector emitter junction voltage. PC at 1 volts, around 1 volts. Here you can see, and repeat the same steps and find out the other reading of collector meter junction and the base current. Increment of base current in the voltage of collector base junction, emitter base junction, you will find the increment in base current. So write down these readings and plot. After noting down the reading, you can plot the graph. You will find again a graph similar to this characteristics. So these are the input characteristics of a NPN type of transistor. So you will find the characteristics as per the user manual in shown. So these are the theoretical explanation, and you can also verify the values as per the practical explanations. So that's how you do and find out the characteristics of a NPN transistor. Similarly, you can find out the PNP transistor also. So now in continuation, we will do the next experiment, which is to study the characteristics of a light emitting diode, LED. So LED is nowadays a very useful component in most of the electronics equipments. So the theory of this LED and different type of color LEDs are given in the user manual. Now this is the experiment procedure. In this we will find out the forward characteristics of an LED. So this is the connection diagram we will have to assemble at the circuit. So we will start to connecting the different connections given in the circuit diagram. For this we will select the 10 volt range as given in the user manual. Now connect positive to a 1k resistance. So this is the 1k resistance here, and output other end of this 1k resistance will be going to a voltmeter. And the voltmeter we are using here 20 volts to 200 volt voltmeter. Now the other end of this voltmeter should be connected to the ground. Now for current, we will connect this voltmeter's positive terminal to the positive of a 200 milliamps ammeter, and the negative of this ammeter will be connected with the anode of the LED. So this is the anode of the LED, and we will connect cathode of this LED, the light emitting diode, to the ground. So this is the ground terminal of the positive supply of 10 volts. Now we will start and verify the circuit before and do the experiment. So after verifying the connections, now we will power on the kit and gradually increase the voltage slowly. So you will find out the voltage and current values and note down the current and voltage and current values of this LED to a paper or a graph paper to plot the graph between voltage and current. So this will be showing the forward characteristics of an LED. So now I will increase the voltage gradually. So this is 0.4 or 0.5 volt here. So this is around 0.3 volt right now. There is no current showing in between the LEDs. Now as I increase the current about 1 volts, so this is the value of current and the LEDs voltage and current values. Now this is the 1.77 volts right now, and the current is very minimal here. Now as the voltage goes up from the 2 volts, the current will exponentially increase. Here you will see as I increase the voltage more than 2 volts, you will see the current. Now you can see the current is exponentially increasing in the larger amount, and also you can observe the LED is also glowing on the circuit. Here you can see, so these are the forward characteristics of an LED. You can note down the readings and plot the graph. You will find the graph as given in the user manual. So this is the graph you will find out after taking and noting down the reading and plotting the graph. So the graph should be similar like this. So difficult operating point is this. At this point the value of current is exponentially increasing. Now moving on to the next experiment, which is to study the characteristics of a NTC, negative temperature coefficient, and PTC, positive temperature coefficient type of thermistor. So we have given two type of thermistors. So we will find out the characteristics of the thermistor. Thermistor just basically works when the temperature reaches, and this will show the current value will be changing as per the thermistor temperature coefficient. So this is the graph of positive temperature coefficient, and this is the negative NTC type of thermistor is given. So the resistance and temperature value will be the graph here. So this is the basic connection and behavior will find out by connecting this and making this connection and circuit diagram. So we will do the circuit diagram. So for this we will require 10 volt supply at the kit. So the knob should be at the 10 volt supply and the value is at the zero. Now connect this positive to the voltmeter and negative to the ground. Now we will connect the thermistor to the voltmeter. So in this we will do the positive or PTC type of thermistor. So the circuit remains the same, just we have to change the type of the thermistor to verify the current and voltage. Now the other end of this thermistor will be connected to the positive of the meter and negative will be connected to the ground. So this is our circuit has been completed. After verifying the circuit, we will power on the kit and you will find some current value here in the positive temperature coefficient thermistor. Now we will turn the value about 5 volts from this knob, so the value of voltage should be increased about 5 volt. So here you can see the value is not reaching about this. So now we will change the emitter to the larger range. For this, switch off the supply of this and connect both the terminals to the larger range emitter. So now we will power on the circuit and you will find out the current value here at the 200 milliamps. Now we will increase the voltage. So we will increase the voltage supply about 5 volts and see the behavior and the current range which is the thermistor is showing. So at middle we have set the value of this potentiometer around the middle and the voltage is now not increasing. Now we will test the thermistor. So for this we will use a heated up soldering iron and place this soldering iron near about the thermistor. So you will see the changes in the current value. So don't touch the soldering iron to the thermistor, just place this to about 1 or 2 centimeter and after some time you will see the value changes in the thermistor value, current value. You can observe the current's value is decreasing So that's how the thermistor in PTC works. So that was the negative positive temperature coefficient thermistor PTC type. Now we will do the NTC type. For this, just we have to change both thermistor from PTC to NTC. Connect both the patch cores to the NTC type of thermistor. Now increase the value of voltage around 5 volts. So this is the 5 volts here. You can see 4.93 approach the 5 volt. At this time, observe the current which is showing at the digital ammeter. So this is the 5.9 or 6 amperes milliamps. Now take the soldering iron and reach the soldering iron near about the thermistor. You will find the current increment in the value of current as the thermistor heated up. Here you can see the value of current is increasing as the thermistor is heating up. You can see the current is exponentially increasing in the value as the temperature rises near the thermistor. So that's how you can calculate the characteristics of the PTC type and NTC type of thermistor and plot the graph of different readings. You will find out the graph of NTC and PTC of characteristics in both the type, similar like this graph which is given in the user manual. So now in today's last experiment, I will explain you the MOSFET characteristics. So these are the power MOSFET, which are a combination of MOS technology and a field effect transistor. So this is the basic BJT and MOS technologies combination. These are very useful nowadays in the industrials and electronics components. So MOSFET characteristics and the theory of the basic structure is given in the user manual here. You can read out the theory for study purpose. All the reasons and working are given in the N-channel or P-channel of MOSFETs. Now these are the procedure for experiment. So this is the circuit diagram of the MOSFET. We will make up the circuit diagram and take out the readings. For this we will start building up the circuit. So for this we will require 0 to 10 volt supply. So the knob is at the 10 volt right now. We will use the 10 volt supply and this should be connected with the 10 ohm resistance of 5 volt. So this is the 10 ohm resistance, 5 volt in 5 volts. Now this resistance and similarly will be connected to the gate terminal of a MOSFET. So this is our MOSFET, the symbol is given on the kit. So the gate terminal should be connected here and we'll also connect a DPM with the gates. So for this we will use the 20 volt DPM and the negative of this should be connected to the ground. Now for drain source terminals we will use drain and connect this to a DPM of 200 volts. So this is the DPM of 200 volts and connect the other end of this DPM to the source. The source should be connected to the ground, so we will connect the source terminal with the ground here. Now we will add the 300 ohm resistance in 5 volts with the voltmeter in continuation and other end of this 300 ohm resistance will be going to the 2 to 20 milliampere DPMs negative and the positive of this should be connected with the positive of a 70 volt DC supply and the negative of this 70 volt supply should be connected with the ground. So all the ground and source terminal should be common. So here you can verify the ground and source terminal is connected with the 70 volt supply with this page codes. And this is a long connection diagram, so verify the connection before circuit power on the circuit to prevent the damages of the component. So we will verify circuit again and then we power on the circuit. After verifying the connections, we will power on this kit. So as I power on the kit, you can see the values are right now zero in all the departments, all the multimeters. Now as the procedure says, first the VGS current, the gate source current should be gate source voltage should be at zero value. Now we will increase the drain source voltage with this regulated power supply here. So the drain source voltage we should increase in steps of 5 volts. So this is the 5 volts, and note down the current corresponding to the drain source voltage. So here you can find out the current is not changing in any case. Also in the milliamperes, the very small amount of current is showing in the milliamps. So till 60 volts, you give the current in 5 volts steps and note down the current and drain source voltage. So here you will find out the graph and note down the readings in the observation table as well, and also find out the graph after plotting the readings. Now we will increase the gate source voltage through this potentiometer knob here, and the drain source voltage should be increased in the different steps. So we will increase it to up to 1 volts. So this is about 1 volt here, 1 or 1.5 volts. Now we again repeat the same steps, increasing the value of drain source voltage in 5 volts. Now your current is larger, so change the reading or selector to the 20 milliamps. Now in 5 volts you will find the voltage and current readings. Note down this voltage and current readings in different steps of 5 volts and plot a graph. You will find out the characteristics as given in the user manual. So these are the characteristics or graph between drain current and drain source voltage at the different values of VGS. So this is the at 2 volts. You can find out the VGS after setting the VGS in different volts. So you can find out the value at 1.5 volt, 1.3 volt, 1.2 volt. Similarly, so you will find out the same graph at different voltage levels. So that's how you find out the MOSFET characteristics through examining this kit. So you can also do the all various experiments which are given in the user manual by connecting the circuit diagrams as per given in the user manual. Now as the last experiment, we will find out the IGBT characteristics. IGBT is the insulated gate bipolar transistor. So this is the basic structure in given in the design. You can study the basic structure in the user manual. The IGBT is the high frequency switching device. This is the circuit diagram given in the user manual. So as per this circuit and procedure, we will find out the characteristics of the IGBT. For this we will make the circuit as given in the user manual. So we will use the 10 volt supply, knob is at 10 volt right now, and connect this to the 10 ohm 5 volt resistance. So this is the 10 ohms 5 volt resistance here, and this should be in further connected with the gate of this IGBT. So this is the IGBT here giving the symbol. You can see the IGBT is connected here. Now we will connect 20 volt voltage meter, DC volt meter, with the supply. So she should be connected to the ground. So here we have connected the voltmeter to get the gate emitter junction voltage. Now from collector we will connect a DPM in between the collector emitter junction. So this is the DPM we have connected in the collector emitter junction. Now for power supply, we will further increase the voltmeter's terminal to 300 ohm, 5 volt resistance. Now this resistance in continuation with connected to the negative of the 20 milliamps DPM for collector current IC, we will measure at this. So positive will be connected to the positive supply of this 70 volt power supply, and negative will be connected with the ground or emitter. So that's how our connection has been done. So now we will power on the circuit after completing the circuit diagram here. Now as the manual says, increase the gate emitter voltage, which is showing at this DPM here, about 4.5 or 4.25 volts. So we will increase the voltage around 4 volt. Here you can see this is the 4.25 around volts. Now we will increase the VDC or the VCE, which is the collector emitter junction voltage, through this knob, which is the 70 volt power supply, 70 volt DC power supply. Gradually increase this power supply and note down the voltage and current readings. Here you can see at very zero value we will find the mu amperes current, milliamps current. Here this is the maximum 20 amperes milliamps current this meter can reach about. So after reaching the value is higher, you can change the meter to the higher range. Before, turn off the kit and change the meter to higher range, so you can easily get the current in the maximum. Now similarly start this step. Here you can see the value is now 22 milliamps. As I increase the value of voltage, you will find out the current is increasing, and sometime you will also find out voltage which is increasing at after a certain value. So this is how the value is now maximum at this. Take the readings in different steps and plot the graph as the user manual shows. At VGE 4.25, take down the VCE and IC current. This is the IC current which I am showing in the ammeter, and the voltage VCE in this. So you will find out the graph as per the, you can see the values are giving same graph. After taking down the reading, you will find out the graph should be similar as given in the user manual. That's how we perform the sum of basic experiment, basic components experiment in through this kit, by finding out the characteristics and the plotting the graph. You can also do the different experiment which are given in all the semiconductor device which are installed with this kit, and find out the different characteristics in the different modes also. For you, the user manual contains all the information about the theories and the experiment purposes. So while doing the experiment, if you find any difficulties, you can easily contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.